Good evening and welcome to AIM High School's commencement for the class of 2022. At this time, I'd ask that you rise, remove your hats, and please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Thank you for all coming tonight. I could make a really corny joke about, aren't we glad that we didn't do this outside? Well, I guess I kind of did, but I'll pass on that anyway. At this time, I'd like to honor and acknowledge our honored guests and staff. Please welcome Deputy Superintendent Sean Stevenson. The Snohomish School District Board of Directors. And the superintendent's cabinet. Thank you for joining us tonight and celebrating our graduates. It's been a long road, full of memories and some good times and some tough times. Tonight, I'd also like to recognize our AIM staff. We're a team. We work so hard together. Each of us has different roles that we play, and none of which is more important than another. The AIM High School staff is special. From our teachers to our support staff, we all work together in a singular goal in mind, and that's to support our students in their growth, success, and achievement. You'll meet our teachers a little bit later when they read their graduate speeches, but I would like to take the opportunity to recognize and thank our behind-the-scenes staff members, the people that pull all the strings and get all those little things done to pull off a special event like tonight, as well as supporting our students. Elizabeth, Linda, Dara, Candy, Anya, Leslie, Tammy, Maria, and Jason, thank you so much for all you do for our students. I'd also like to recognize June Shirey for her years of dedication as the director of AIM High School. June, would you please stand and be recognized? I hope retirement's treating you well and you didn't have to deal with COVID. Yeah, kind of. Tonight we'll focus on celebrating our graduates. That's you. You're the guests of honor. You deserve all of the attention. You've faced challenges, persevered, and tonight you're enjoying the fruits of your labor. We're here to celebrate you and what you've accomplished. We'll honor and recognize each of our graduates in attendance. We have a very special ceremony, a tradition that highlights the AIM community and the individual accomplishments of each of our graduates. To kick things off tonight, I'd like to invite Elizabeth Artati, AIM graduate, to share a special address to the class of 2022.
Hello, class of 2022 and guests. I'm Elizabeth Artati, despite the odds, a graduating senior here at AIM High School. It's crazy that I even get to say that, because just a few months ago, I did not think that that would be an option for me. But now, through perseverance, kindness, and a bit of luck, I get to be here talking to you all today. My high school experience up to this point hasn't been an easy one, as is true for many students here. My freshman year was my only full year at high school. At the time, I thought that just adjusting to be a teenager and talking to the upperclassmen theater kids would be the hardest part of it. But then, my sophomore year, we went into lockdown and stayed in lockdown all throughout my junior year. Over that time, I made and lost friends, had my first super serious relationship, and I grew a lot as a person. Finally, my senior year started, and we were all back in person. I was attending SHS at the time, and it was a rough start to the year, but everyone was doing the best that they could. But then, in October, my mom died, and I dropped out of school. Obviously, everyone was sorry and sympathetic, but it was the most difficult time in my life. This continued until the end of first semester when my best friend, who has been attending AIM since the beginning of our sophomore year, suggested that when I come back, I come to AIM instead. I honestly think that that is the best decision that I could have made. Everyone here has been so kind and understanding, and the staff has helped me more than I could have ever expected. It's largely because of their support and the support of my friends and family that I'm able to be here graduating with the rest of my class. It's no secret that alternative schools can have a bit of a negative reputation, but I am so proud to have gone here. There are so many reasons why schools like AIM are important, and my story is a prime example of one. I have never before seen a school who so clearly cares about all of its students. To be honest, I don't entirely know what's left for me, but it's because of this year and coming to this school with all of its hardships and graces that I can say with honesty that I can handle whatever comes next. So many people have supported me throughout my life. Thank you to my dad and siblings, to my friends and teachers. And a special thank you, because even if she's not here anymore, I would not have gotten to be where I am today as successfully or compassionately without being raised by such a wonderful mother. I know that she would be proud of me. If you take anything away from this speech, let it be this: despite the odds. I think more than anything that describes what this school is about. So today and every day forward, keep living despite the odds.
All right. Thank you, Elizabeth. Give her another round. So I like to tell a story. When I was hired 2 years ago, one of the first experiences I got to do was join a staff meeting via Zoom. And it happened to be the staff meeting where the AIM teachers were picking which students they would write speeches for. And it was at that very moment that I realized I'm in the right spot. I'm where I want to be, around people who love kids and see the best in them and will fight and argue with each other to decide who gets to give whose speech. Tonight, I'm going to invite, and our staff members will invite our graduates to stand. It's an invitation. They don't have to. But these speeches are written from the heart and are a gift from each of us to them. So tonight, I'd like to start with Cyrus Holt. Cyrus? Although his plans and next steps are fluid, Cyrus is a young man that knows exactly what he wants to do and what he needs to do to get there. Cyrus wants to apply his interest in welding to the HVAC or automotive industries before venturing out on his own as an entrepreneur and business owner. I've witnessed firsthand that when Cyrus decides that he wants to accomplish something, he can and will do it. Cyrus, I'm glad to have been able to watch you grow, respond to my high expectations this year, and I know that you're ready. Best wishes. Jesse Minton. Jesse, this is my 29th year in education. I know I don't look that old. But you are by far one of the most genuinely kind students that I have ever encountered. You would see me giving a tour to new students. You would come over, introduce yourself, and immediately draw them in and make them feel welcome and appreciated. Later, I would observe you following up. You would always offer a help and support and make them feel welcome. I started to call you our unofficial AIM Welcoming Committee because that's what you did. It does not surprise me that you're interested in elder care as a career. Your kind heart and compassion will serve you well in your future as well as your clients. Thank you, Jesse. Annika Norton. Annika, I've really enjoyed getting to know you this semester. Between Snow Isle Skill Center and Running Start, you've only needed a few classes at AIM to meet your graduation requirements. You've continued to be an excellent student while keeping up with both Running Start Cosmetology program and AIM academics. I wish that you would have been able to have been with us longer, but I'm glad that we were able to have the time with you that we did. Annika, thank you for putting your trust in AIM. We appreciate you. At this time, I'd like to invite Dan Stone, AIM High School English and Social Studies teacher.
Good evening. First, I'd like to say overall that I'm really proud of these seniors. They've really persevered through really unforeseen, obviously, circumstances, and it's just really impressive. First, I'd like to talk about Leslie Arias Perez. Leslie always comes in with a positive attitude, and I think when she came to AIM, she really benefited from our smaller learning environment. She's a very kind and diligent worker, but also setting her goals and meeting them. She's also a proud and caring mother of an adorable little lady, Idalia, who was also in our daycare at AIM, so I could hear her through the walls. It was all pleasant. I assure you, her interests include outside of school. She works quite a bit, hanging out with friends, and also, of course, being full-time mom. Congratulations, Leslie. Jasmine Gonzalez. Jasmine joined us at AIM to get more one-on-one help, and she's really thrived in her time at AIM. I've worked with her for the last several years, both virtually and in person. I've always really appreciated her positive attitude. She's also very successful in the Snow Isle program, where she was in the translation and interpretation program. In the future, she's considering pursuing a career in that specialty or a similar field. I'm really excited for her future. Congratulations, Jasmine. Jacob Jackson. We were really excited to have Jacob return to us this year, and we were concerned that we might lose him, but he returned to get his diploma this year, and I really admire his persistence, as it has been an easy path, of course. I'm really proud that he was able to complete what he needed to do as of 10:30 this morning, I think it was, but who's counting? We're all very proud. of your ability to keep going and accomplish what you've had set out to do. And I'm very hopeful for the future for Jacob. Congratulations. Haley Mabry. I've had Haley for a couple different years, both as history and English teacher. And so I kind of was able to witness firsthand some of her talents as a student, but also as a person. She's really self-motivated, hardworking, and goal-oriented. Always been really conscientious about not just getting things done, but doing them well. She's a very well-rounded individual as well, balancing school, a variety of interests, including music and singing. That's a tease for later. The skills that she developed will serve her very well in college. And after high school, she hopes to pursue a career in the field of education. Congratulations, Haley. Madeline Pulliam. Maddie came to us a few years ago to help individualize her education. She's been very successful in the Snow Isle program, the animation program there, and seems to really enjoy that creativity. She is very passionate about art and has a very creative streak to her. After high school, she's planning on attending Western Washington University to pursue her interests. And I'm sure with her attention to detail, I'm sure she will do excellent in whatever she decides to pursue. Congratulations. Let's see. Next up is Courtney, our science teacher.
So I'm going to start with Esther Kirkman. So Esther joined AIM during second semester and has been a wonderful addition to our student body. She is quiet and prefers to work independently, but she is friendly to all. She has been described by staff as creative, focused, reflective, and determined. These are all qualities that will help Esther reach her goals in life. We wish you the best of luck. Congratulations. Owen Skinner. Owen prefers to work independently and at his own pace, but his work was described by staff as super creative and detail-oriented. He digs deep into topics and gives his best effort. Owen is a drummer and enjoys music. His determination and perseverance got him to the finish line. AIM staff looks forward to hearing what the future holds for him. Congratulations, Owen. Anthony Berger. Anthony is in my robotics class, and I couldn't ask for a better team player. The robotics curriculum we use emphasizes the idea of gracious professionalism, which is defined as a way of doing things that encourages high-quality work, emphasizes the values of others, and respects individuals and the community. Anthony lives up to these values and really is a silent leader in the class. He is known by the staff as super friendly, grateful to everyone that has helped him, and a very conscientious and polite young man. His amazing smile will be missed, but we all know that he will succeed at whatever he puts his mind to. You were definitely fought over, Anthony Berger. You have made an impact on us. And next up, we have Derek.
Welcome, everybody. It's great to see you. Thanks for joining us on this just awesome, wonderful evening. And I just want to also compliment the focus and determination that these students showed us this year, and it's pretty awesome. Lillian Allison. Lillian is reaching the finish line with her strong will and tenacity. She is a very capable student who has positively influenced her peers. Lillian has a warm, infectious, and positive personality. She cares about others, demonstrates compassion and empathy, while maintaining her positive personality. And these are traits that will suit her well as she pursues a career in real estate. It has been wonderful to watch her grow and face opportunities, take chances, and challenge herself to grow and flourish. Through these learning experiences, Lillian is realizing her full potential, and her potential has no limits. Congratulations. Matthew Denny. Matthew is passionate. His big personality lights up any room, and he is a social butterfly who thrives on relationships. He has been working hard to graduate this year while maintaining a job, and when things got challenging toward the end of the year, Matthew made some needed changes to ensure his success. Highlighting that ability to persevere. With his natural sociability, Matt will be successful directly serving and working with automobiles as he has a passion for working with cars and car audio. This is a very important moment, and we are here to cheer Matt on as he invests in himself and his future. Congratulations. Zarissa Hurley. Zarissa has been a very consistent student. She is someone that can be counted on to follow through, step up, and take the lead. Her passion, positive energy, optimism, and infectious personality should be celebrated and will take her far. Zarissa is kind to others, compassionate, and genuine. She will attend Ever Community College, become an esthetician, ultimately own her own business. Zarissa does not let obstacles get in the way of her success, yet she finds another way through. Her drive and determination will lead her to great heights. And this is just the beginning. Congratulations. Nikhil Johnson. Nikhil is driven and determined. She is conscientious of others, kind, well-mannered, and she demonstrates a tremendous amount of personal resiliency. She has shown she can stand up to any challenge. Helping and providing service to others is something that is ingrained into her personality. Nikhil has resonated with psychology and human services, fields that she plans to study at the Everett Community College. Her passion and enthusiasm will resonate with those that she serves. She's a very selfless person and genuinely wishes to better the lives of others. Nikhil is an inspiration. Congratulations. Carson Raymond. Carson started at AIM in 2019 and has made a definite, impactful, and lasting impression. We have been privileged to observe her success. Carson is resilient, motivated, kind, caring, and extremely driven. She consistently sets high standards for herself and has risen to meet these high expectations, all while maintaining outside employment commitments, and she has been an influential support for others, willingly being a peer others can rely on. She hopes to focus her studies on a business-related degree with the goal of opening her own business. Carson will genuinely be missed by our AIM community. Congratulations. At this time, I'd like to take a little break in the speeches and invite Haley Mabry to do a vocal performance for you.
this is what you meant when you said that you were spent. And now it's time to build from the bottom of the pit right to the top. Don't hold back. Packing my bags and giving the Academy a rain check. I don't ever want to let you down. I don't ever want to leave this town. 'Cause after all, this city never sleeps at night. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am? So this is where you fell, and I am left to sell. The path to heaven runs through clouds of mouth to the top. Don't hold back. Turning to rags and giving the commodities a rain check. I don't ever want to let you down. I don't ever want to leave this town. 'Cause after all, this city never sleeps at night. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am? It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am? This road never looks so lonely. This house doesn't burn down slowly to ashes. To ashes. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am? It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am?
Haley, you performed at last year's graduation ceremony, and I don't know what we're going to do to replace you. Thank you so much. Let's give her another hand. We're very, very proud of you, Haley. At this time, I'd like to welcome Nick Hammonds up. He's an English and social English and math teacher.
Well, congrats, grads. Hey, this is quite an accomplishment for all you guys. And the biggest advice I can give you guys as you move on into your professions, move on to college, whatever you're going to pursue, always have confidence and belief in yourself and everything that you do. That can take you a long way. So really proud of all you guys. Congrats to the class of 2022. Really proud of you guys. Hey, first up, we have Carson Clark. Carson, you have faced quite a few challenges this past year. You have attended a new school, made new friends, and have had to adapt to an unfamiliar environment. This takes a tremendous amount of courage, adjustment, and resiliency. These three values you have possessed since starting at AIM High School will serve you a great deal moving forward. Remember, when faced with new challenges as an adult, to always believe in yourself and not give up on yourself. I've really enjoyed having you as a student, and congrats on graduating. Andrew Conley. Congrats on graduating high school, Andrew. There have been so many challenges you and your fellow classmates have faced over the last few years. You have set goals for yourself and have accomplished them. You've done an outstanding job facing your fears and attacking them head on. Remember moving forward that a great acronym for fear is false evidence appearing real. You will face obstacles, challenges, and new opportunities, but we believe you can achieve anything you set your mind to. Congrats, Andrew. Morgan Dyer. Congrats on finishing high school, Morgan. You've shown a tremendous amount of resiliency in accomplishing this feat. I can remember Anya telling me about when you two worked together to map out a plan of what it would look like for you to graduate. Anya said she was speechless seeing the reaction from you and the realization of how close you were. This is a pretty cool moment for you, and I want you to know that the best is ahead for you. Keep working hard, facing your challenges, and continue to show resiliency in everything that you do. Congrats, Morgan. Esmeralda Ruiz. Congrats, Ezzy. I'm so proud of your commitment throughout the time I've had you in class. You have shown confidence, belief, and a determination to reach the goals you have set for yourself. You have made such a positive impact on the people around you. Your fun-loving spirit will only inspire all the people you encounter in your future. I know you have talked about your past mistakes, but what I remember is it all about where you're going, and from what I can see, your future is very bright. Hey, Ezzy, guess what? You graduated. And So I've got one more special where Ezzy, if you can stay standing for us, please. So I want, we got a special moment for Ezzy, as she was named our Snow Isle Student of the Year for 2022. So your instructor, Vicky, could not be here tonight, but she wanted to pass along the message that your positive energy, your joy, your happiness, the way you work with others contributes to such a great environment that you have in your cosmetology class at Snow Isle. She couldn't be more proud of you, and she knows that your best days are in front of you. So she wanted to pass along congratulations. And
thank you so much.
Yeah, you've also been awarded $300 in scholarship money, and you're also going to get a customized award that you'll receive next week at AIM High School. So here you go. Congratulations. Okay, and next up we have Linda Wetherill.
Hi there. After this, a little bit. I want to introduce you to some amazing ladies. This is from my heart, ladies. Avery Anderson. Avery has an inner quiet strength that is amazing. She has shown perseverance, dedication, energy, and effort to overcome all obstacles in her life. She refused to fail despite many challenges. She has chosen not to create excuses, but to seek opportunities to succeed. She's my strong, silent type. She will be sorely missed at AIM and by me. Avery, you're my hero. Elizabeth Artardi. Elizabeth has only been with us a short time, but heck, she has made a lasting impact on me and the AIM family. Her smile and positive attitude has brightened up the school and the classroom. I wholeheartedly agree with them that Elizabeth brings many positive qualities to share. She's thoughtful, determined, and consistently passionate. Congratulations, Elizabeth. You have graduated. Faith, where are you? I kept my promise to you. All these years, I told her that she make it here, I will talk about her, and I won't cry. Okay, so far. Faith, you're such a bright, intelligent, kind, beautiful young lady. You have the inner strength along with diligence and devotion and gift to overcome obstacle. You have put great deal of work and effort to get to this point. You have such a fierce sense of dedication and stamina. Your family, AIM family again, and me are so proud of you. You will be great as a teacher. You go, girl. Kalea Bdipu. Kalea Dipu has a unique and wonderful spirit. She has a wonder in her expression and innate desire to do well in life. Her smiles, as you can see, lights up the, look at that. I am so impressed with her. Kalea lives in a world of creativity and acceptance. She's grounded and talented in spirit. I truly believe that AIM and the world is a much better place with you in it. Congratulations, Kalea, you did it. Last but not least at all, Sylvia Swentke. Come on. She is a force of nature. She believes in fairness and doing what's right. When something needs to be done, like finishing up, she finds a way to do it. When she believes in something, she commits herself with a cause and great passion. She comes with belief system and determination and dedication. She speaks up loudly for what she believes in. I believe that she will tackle life with a similar amount of passion and grit. Congratulations. At this time, I'd like to invite Sam Ford.
Uh-oh, open mic. I was thinking as I was sitting there, one of the many special things about this place is like I could give a speech about a lot more kids. I only get four, but I think all the teachers probably could say that, where one of the beauties is you really get to know the stories of these kids and connect with them. And it's just difficult to do with much bigger size. So sorry I couldn't give more, but I'll give a few. Peyton Grubert. Peyton is one of the kindest, most grounded students I've ever met. She carries herself like an old soul who understands more about life at her age than perhaps she should. Peyton is optimistic, magnetic, and empathetic, and she has a great head on her shoulders and an even greater heart. Peyton has navigated the storms of her life with strength beyond her years, and like a steady sailboat, she's undaunted by the waves of challenge or uncertainty. She knows where she's from, and she knows where she's going. In truth, she has her eyes on the skies, desiring to follow in the footsteps of her father and be a pilot. Congratulations, Peyton. I am not simply proud of you, I'm proud to have known you. Colby Nicole Jones. Colby Nicole has faced the challenges of her life with courage and tenacity. Fearlessly committed to her goals, Nicole has proven to be one of the hardest working students I've ever had. First to ask about any homework, first to begin her work, first to submit her work, and first to tell me why she shouldn't be having to do this work. She is smart, quick-witted, and shrewd. Nicole speaks her mind with confidence, directness, and a little bit of sass. But don't be fooled by this hard exterior. There's a soft heart behind the facade. Bottom line, she is a young, charismatic woman who I trust will find success as a future veterinarian or whatever else she chooses to put her energies toward. Congratulations, Nicole. It has been my joy and privilege to be your teacher. Caden Southard. From the beginning, Caden has always impressed me with his consistency and his steadfastness. Your parents should be proud of you as you are a young man of character, dependability, and quiet strength. And he's not quiet because he doesn't have anything to say, but because he possesses an attribute usually learned later in life, discernment. He is, therefore, slow to speak, quick to listen, slow to become angry. Without question, he works harder than many, but he also works a lot smarter. If I were going to describe Caden in a word, it would be faithful. I found him to be faithful to his Lord, to his family, to his responsibilities, and to his community. Congratulations, Caden. Texas is blessed to have you. And my last unfortunate one, I wish I had more, is Grace Wiseman. Grace Wiseman, known affectionately as G-Dub Money to me, is a determined young woman who knows what she wants out of life. In that small frame is a lot of spunk, moxie, fire, and passion. Grace feels deeply, thinks sensibly, and cares greatly. When I first met Grace, I observed it as a quiet and kind of reserved wallflower. But as the year progressed, she blossomed into the fullness of her true self, loud, proud, and present. Unsurprisingly, she has every detail of her future planned out, intending to study cosmetology or interior design, basically dedicating herself to making things beautiful. Congratulations, Grace. May you experience the same depth of beauty in life that you bring to it. And our next presenter is Yulia, one of our math teachers.
Good evening, families. Thank you for being here, and thank you for your support all these years of these amazing individuals. We all know what hard and important work it is to support these people and to... I didn't mean for it to sound like that. It's wonderful work to support these amazing people, and it's very much appreciated. So thank you. Let me tell you a little bit about some of them right here. So Nathan Gerard. I met Nate when he came to AIM as a freshman. My first impression of Nate was that of a strong student and athlete with a positive attitude who knew who I knew would do great. Our staff became a cheer section for Nate from the get-go. Always with a smile, Nate arrived ready to learn and tackle whatever problems came his way. It wasn't always easy, but he figured everything out. In addition to AIM, Nate successfully completed some classes at Snow Isle and has also been holding a job while working towards graduation. Well, Nate, you crossed that finish line, and we are very proud of you. Ashley Matila. Ashley's road to graduation was not an easy one. Finding a safe environment where she could learn while being a full-time mom was a key to Ashley's academic success. In her AIM application, Ashley wrote, "My daughter has inspired me to be better in life and to make my future brighter." That inspiration, like a candlelight, helped Ashley go through some dark times in her life and not give up on school. Now you have two children, Ashley, and your high school diploma. You did it. And we wish you a future full of light and inspiration. Devin Wallace. Staff at AIM described Devin as a polite and friendly guy who can get a lot of work done when he sets his mind to it. Devin is great at independent work, and he also likes to work with his hands. Devin admits that English and history are his strengths, and even though he doesn't mention math in this list, he did great in his Algebra 2 class. Your time at AIM wasn't long, Devin, but it was nice having you here. We wish you all the best and congratulations. Marcus Willard. Marcus, it was fun watching you grow these years. I remember you coming to AIM High School before the pandemic. You were polite and responsible. You wanted to do your best. Online learning during the pandemic was a setback for a lot of students, but you came back strong. I will never forget working with you on geometry. You knew that those credits and skills will be helpful to you in your career. You wanted to get done with school and start working at Boeing. Completing the Snow Isle Aerospace program and your classes at AIM required a lot of perseverance, and you achieved your goal. We're proud of you, Marcus. Congratulations. Andrew Wheeler. I got the privilege to be Andrew's math teacher as well as his mentor. Honestly, I struggle to name something Andrew hasn't mastered. He had a great knowledge of himself and was always willing to share insights about social emotional health in our advisory class. Articulate and mathematically gifted, Andrew is also super creative. Ambitious and hardworking, Andrew completed the animation program at Snow Isle, and we expect him to have a brilliant career in arts, or music, or science, or anything else he would like to explore. Congratulations, Andrew. And now, our art and ASB teacher, Heather.
Hi, Hi, everyone. I'm Heather. I've got to warn you, I am a crier, and I did not bring any Kleenex. So if I start bawling my eyes out up here, please just join in with happy tears. That would make me feel so much better and make it easier for me to get through these speeches for these amazing, fantastic, stupendous students that are right there. So before I begin my student speeches, I would like to tell you graduates two wishes that I have for you. So the first one is to remember the investment. Look out there. Look over there. Look at each other. You have all made huge investments in each other, and you've had the support of so many to get to where you are, and just remember that. Really feel that for a second. Just really feel that investment. So my wish for you is that you let that investment shine and that you choose to invest in others. Pay it forward. You got this. My second wish for you is that you create a beautiful life. I have the coolest job ever. I always say that. I'm an art teacher. I get to watch these creative students shine and find their creativity, and I just want them to create the life that they want, and that's the goal. So sometimes things are tough. We've been through a lot together, but you have learned how to fight through, to get through the hard things, and to create something beautiful, and one of those things is this night right here. So congratulations. You guys are my heart. Also enjoy the simple things. We talk a lot about that in class, mindfulness, all that good stuff. Just carry that on. All right, so here's where I cry. Deep breath. Right? I got this. So the first student I would like to talk about is near and dear to my heart, Isabel Hines. So Isabel. Isabel is an innovative thinker who thrives during independent tasks. She is deliberate in her thoughts and actions and doesn't race to make judgments. She's creative and attentive to detail, and that will serve you very well. She prefers to work independently and uses her time to carefully consider her options, to really think about an assignment before she jumps in, and then when it's her time to do an assignment, she shines. Once she has an idea, she works diligently to develop it, and it really shows in her work. We can't wait to see what the future holds for you. Keep in touch. There's a bright future in store for you, Isabel. Congratulations. Oh man, another one. Here we go. Heather cries again. Ella Pierce. So Ella is a superstar student. My biggest regret this school year is that I did not get to have her in an art class, and I'm like, Ella is quick to smile and just bring positivity into the classroom. She's optimistic and very goal-oriented as well. Once she sets her mind to something, she's going to accomplish it, so just get out of her way. Her quiet leadership inspires others just by her positivity and her willingness to dig in and do the hard work that needs to be done. She's super creative and inspired. She's focused, resilient, and action-oriented. You can always count on Ella to be attentive and inquisitive. She puts her all into every activity and assignment and is forward-thinking. She lights up the room. Congratulations, Ella. Mia Sersley, where's Mia? Yay. Mia is thoughtful and fun and super creative as well. She's been a great addition to our learning community this year. She's super reliable, always comes into class with a smile, works really hard, cares about her schoolwork, gives it her all, and always seeks understanding. She's got a plan for the future. She knows the next step starting tomorrow. She's got this. She comes to school ready to work and has future goals in mind. Her willingness to listen to opinions and ideas of others and share her insights brought levity to the classroom. It was really inspiring. She's a hard worker who tackles activities and projects with focus and intention. Her enthusiasm for learning is evident and appreciated. Mia, you will do great things. Congratulations. Ryan Travis, where's Ryan? So Ryan joined AIM recently, so just second semester this year, and he did an amazing job of acclimating to our school culture, stepping up, and just becoming a great member of our classes and our community. He's super friendly and adaptable. He always walked into class with a warm smile and a great greeting. That is so nice. You get that in the morning. So I really appreciate that from Ryan. He joined our ASB class and was a valuable member of that team. He's super chill, friendly, and has an easygoing personality. He prefers to work at his own pace, but understands what needs to be accomplished and will put in the effort that's necessary. Ryan's future is bright. Congratulations, Ryan. And finally, Dylan Webb. Where's Dylan? Woo! So Dylan's a guy with a big heart and a creative spirit. He's funny and a great conversationalist. He loves music and has his eye on the future. Dylan had a staggering amount of work to get to this day and graduate, but he set his eye on the prize, that finish line of graduation, and he made it work. It was really fun to sit back and watch him throughout the last year. So he was a student where I knew I could pick on him a little bit. So I got to be the teacher that was like, Dylan, get your work done. And he took it and he made it work. So much fun to watch him shine. He does his best work when he has someone cheering him on. So let's all keep doing that as his community. We're cheering for you, Dylan. You got this. Great things are ahead. Congratulations. So I have the great honor to introduce our next student speaker. So hopefully without a dry eye in the room, I would like to welcome Colby Nicole Jones to share with you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Hello, everybody. My name is Colby Nicole Jones, and I would like to start this off by saying thank you to everybody that is here, specifically Doug Plucker, Derek DeGroot, as well as all of the Ames staff for giving me this amazing opportunity to graduate. I now know that I am capable of success, and AIM has helped show me this. I would also like to take a moment to reminisce about the past. 2020 through 2021, we went through COVID. That was my sophomore year. We got sent home on lockdown. Gladly enough, we survived the pandemic. Sadly, though, this was a tough time for not only the staff and students, but for the entire world, too. This was the first pandemic in 100 years. We had to cope and find new ways to live a new normal life, wearing masks every day and not going out unless it's needed. It was hard on everyone, and my heart goes out to everybody who lost a loved one during the pandemic, and I am so sorry. Through the course of my 4 years of high school, the most memorable and key memories that I have are being accepted into Snow Isle Tech Skills Veterinary Assisting Program, becoming an intern at 17 at an exotic veterinary clinic, graduating no matter the challenges I faced, and online learning. Enrolling in AIM High School sophomore year when June Shirey was our principal was the best decision I have ever made, and it just feels like it was yesterday. I am so glad that I've been able to make it this far in my life, and I am so excited for the next chapter to begin. My school has gone above and beyond helping me and other students succeed. They do everything in their power to help us prepare for the future and graduate. With my diploma, I can now go to college and start my career. This is such a huge time in my life, and even though I am excited, I am also terrified. I will be 18, a graduate of high school, and I will be living on my own soon. It's scary, but life does not slow down, and if I am not ready now, I never will be. Looking back on my years, though, I do have some regrets. I wish that I never messed up my ninth grade year. I had to make up for it and take time doing those classes when I could have been focusing on something more important. But it was too late to do anything about it. All I could do is tell the future students to please do your homework and get it all done, and you will graduate, and I promise it'll be worth every second. Graduating is going to bring me so many things. And I am so thrilled to go to college and start getting my degree to become a vet tech and then a full-fledged veterinarian. I once again could not do it without the help of my amazing friends, family, and AIM High School. My friends and family have always been there for me, supported me, and have had my back no matter what. AIM is such a uniquely wonderful school. I have had such an amazing time here at AIM during my high school career, and I hope that they continue to do great things in the future. I could not have done it without everybody at AIM, the staff, the students, the teachers, everyone. AIM is the only school I have gone to where they show that they really only care about the student's success. They want you to get your diploma, which is why I love AIM. And if there is anything else that I could say to the new students that are starting high school, is please do not procrastinate. It will not help you. You need to get your homework done, and I wish I did that from the beginning. And if you need help, just please ask. I promise somebody will be there to help you, especially at AIM. After realizing my mistakes, I did my homework religiously and passed with great grades. Anyone can do it if they just put their minds to it. You can get your responsibilities done. Thank you.
I just wanted to make sure they could all see you, Colby. The mic. I didn't want the mic in the way. We have a couple of awards that we're going to be presenting to students tonight. They don't know they're receiving awards. The first award is that I'm going to be presenting is called the AIM Staff Award. And the criteria for this award are recognizing a student that oftentimes flies under the radar. They're always there. They always get their work done, but sometimes they don't get the recognition and the acknowledgement that they deserve. I'm extremely honored to present this year's award to Jesse Minton. At this time, Derek, our counselor, Derek DeGroot, is going to present the Most Inspirational Student Award.
All right. Each year, the AIM staff chooses one graduate who's inspired us, made a great impact on our school community, and this student has inspired us all to be better educators, to continue to improve the way we serve our students. It's a bit of an AIM tradition that I'm really thrilled to be able to present tonight. This student, simply put, has motivated us to bring our best to the table. We have known this student since 2019. She has demonstrated an extraordinary amount of persistence through adverse times. She's been resilient, motivated, and despite the hardships that she's faced, she's continued to persevere. She's tenacious, willing to put in the effort it takes to succeed. She's funny, creative, and a real go-getter. She's logical and decisive, has not allowed any obstacles to be a barrier. Consistent, driven, determined. She is conscientious of others, kind, and very well-mannered, demonstrating care and concern for others at AIM. She made a concerted effort to manage multiple activities while maintaining a positive attitude. She was a very strong scholarship candidate, receiving several awards through the local scholarship program. Additionally, she was selected to receive the Washington State Governor's Scholarship. She also successfully completed her Snow Isle Tech Skills Center program in veterinary studies. This student plans to eventually obtain a doctorate in veterinary medicine, and we are so excited for her. Please stand, Colby Nicole Jones.
At this time, it is my honor and privilege to introduce Deputy Superintendent Sean Stevenson to address and accept the class of 2022.
I really appreciate the opportunity to be here today with you to celebrate these students and the many accomplishments they've had to bring us to this point today. More than at any time, you've had to demonstrate amazing determination, grit, resilience, as you've not only grown up in your high school years during a global pandemic, but thrived. You've tackled so many things we've never seen before, from remote schooling to ever-changing COVID guidance, just to name a few. These skills you developed will help you become the great leaders in our society. I'd like to take a moment to recognize the leaders here at AIM, Principal Mr. Doug Plucker and the AIM staff. Family and friends here with us today, thank you for giving us the opportunity to work with these amazing students. While they've done the work to get here today, it takes years of support, guidance, and sometimes that hard love to help them to become the great young adults that they are. Enjoy this day and this accomplishment. Remember, this ceremony is a beginning and not an end. Congratulations, students and families. As Deputy Superintendent of Snohomish School District, it's my great honor to present the graduating class of 2022 to the Snohomish School Board under the leadership of Mr. Jay Hagen. I certify that the seniors before us have completed all requirements established by the Snohomish School District in the state of Washington and have successfully earned their high school diplomas. Mr. Hagen and school board members, I present to you the graduating class of 2022.
Lillian Allison. Avery Anderson. Leslie Arias Perez. Elizabeth Artadi. Anthony Berger. Carson Clark. Andrew Conley. Faith Cox. Matthew Denny. Calais Depew. Morgan Dyer. Nathan Gerard. Jasmine Gonzalez. Peyton Grubert. Isabel Hines. Cyrus Holt. Zarissa Hurley. Jacob Jackson. Nikhil Johnson. Colby Nicole Jones. Esther Kirkman. Haley Mayberry. Ashley Matilla. Jesse Minton. Monica Norton. Elizabeth Kate Pierce. Madeline Pulliam. Carson Raymond. Esmeralda Ruiz. Sylvie Schwentke. Owen Skinner. Caden Southard. Mia Sersley. Ryan Travis. Devin Wallace. Dylan Webb. Andrew Wheeler. Marcus Willard. Grace Wiseman.
Let's give him another hand.
Before we conclude our ceremony with the turning of the tassel tradition, I'd like to give a few instructions for meeting up with your graduate. Graduates will recess out of the auditorium first, and then families and guests will follow behind them to meet up outside of the pack or inside the foyer area. In order to respect each graduate, we ask that guests stay seated until all the graduates have recessed before exiting. Okay, graduates, please rise. This ceremony does not represent an end. It represents a beginning of the next chapter in your life. Like any good story, and we all have our own stories to tell, each chapter builds upon the ones before. The turning of the tassel tradition from right to left represents the turning of the page in your life script. It's a simple act that represents a big moment in your life, and we're all very proud of you. Are you ready?
No.
On three, one, two, three.